In this episode of Star Hopping, we'll look at the Virgo Coma region and show you how to find these beautiful deep sky objects. Messier 85. Messier 88. And the missing Messier galaxy, M91.
All right, let's go star hopping.
Hey, hello, hi, and welcome to episode 51 of Star Hopping. I'm Dave Hearn, and I'm feeling totally renewed to be your host. In this series of programs, you show the most beautiful sights in the night sky and explain exactly how to find them with your binoculars or your telescope. Well, after our celebration for 50 episodes last time, we have another notable event that occurred this past week. My YouTube channel went past the 500 subscriber mark. I've been watching for that for a while now, and I predicted that would happen in the last 2 weeks of February or so. My prediction for the coveted 1,000 subscriber mark is August of 2018. Let's see how accurate that is. For those of you that have been subscribed, thank you so much for your support. So in this episode, we've come around another year and the realm of the galaxies are now 30 degrees above the eastern horizon, about 10:30 p.m. local time. As I've mentioned previously in the three episodes of the Realm series, this is a very complicated part of the sky, and to positively identify a particular galaxy, you'll need to be pretty disciplined and step through the star hops very carefully. It's really best to do this kind of a galaxy hop with a fellow observer, so you can make the moves together, each with your own telescope, to verify every galaxy along the way. So we have three interesting targets to do tonight, and the path kind of skirts around the main cluster of galaxies. We'll check out the first target right after this break. Star Hopping would like to thank our wonderful supporters on Patreon. Your contributions will allow us to create and provide more quality astronomy content. We appreciate your generosity and support.
Star hopping target number one.
Messier 85, otherwise known as NGC 4382, is a lenticular galaxy in the constellation of Coma Berenices. It's one of the brighter members of the Coma Virgo cluster. M85 was discovered in 1781 by Pierre Méchain and was confirmed the same year by Charles Messier. Sometimes it makes me wonder why the list is not the Méchain list, because he found so many of the objects on it. Well, we can remember when we say M85 that the M stands for both Messier and Méchain. So let's strike out once again into the Realm. I'd recommend that you go back and check out the earlier Realm episodes, which were episodes 18, 19, and 20 of Star Hopping. In all the star hops, we always use the same starting point and initial hopping steps. I'll review them again for you this time, but it'll be a great refresher to check out the earlier episodes. I'll provide links to them in the episode notes for this week's show, found at starhopping.org/SH051. So on to M85. This galaxy shines at magnitude 9.1, and it's about 9 minutes of arc across in its longer dimension, so I would say that this is a moderate difficulty star hop. So we'll start out as we always have, at bright second magnitude De Nebula, at the tip of the tail of the constellation of Leo the Lion. Move about 2.5 degrees down and to the left from De Nebula to fifth magnitude Omicron Leonis. The next one's kind of a tough move, so get your bearings and check beforehand with binoculars. Exactly 5 degrees down and slightly to the left lies fifth magnitude 6 Coma Berenices. Now we'll set off in a different direction from before. We'll move about 3 degrees to the left to fourth magnitude 11 Coma Berenices. Now move 1 degree to the lower left, and you should see the glow of Messier 85 coming into your wide field eyepiece. M85's large, bright oval core is shrouded in a much fainter halo extending north to south. Larger telescopes will show that the galaxy has a brilliant nucleus within a 2 minutes of arc wide core, all embedded in a faint halo. It's really pretty. M85 is 60 million light years away, and it's estimated to be 125,000 light years across. It's one of the largest and brightest galaxies in the Coma Virgo supercluster. So now let's take a bypass route around the main core of the Virgo cluster to find our next target. We'll travel to it right after this break. Would you like to see the scripts, images, and star charts that I present in each episode of Star Hopping in written form? Well, you can. They're available in our Field Notes digital guides that we produce for each and every episode of Star Hopping. Field Notes guides are available right back to episode 1 of Star Hopping, and you can put them on your phone or tablet to take with you out to your favorite observing site. Our field notes are available in our digital store individually in seasonal bundles or by subscription, where you can receive these useful digital guides in your inbox sent to you the same day as when we publish each new episode of Star Hopping. Check out our selection of field notes in our digital bookstore by visiting starhopping.org/digital store.
Hopping target number 2.
Messier 88, aka NGC 4501, is a gorgeous spiral galaxy in the constellation of Coma Berenices, and it's one of the giant spiral members of the Coma Virgo galaxy cluster. A quick shout out goes to Gaster72, who requested this target this past week. M88 is one of the more rewarding galaxies in the Virgo cluster for smaller telescopes. It's a compact spiral that's inclined about 36 degrees to our line of sight, so its appearance is similar to the Andromeda galaxy, M31, but on a much smaller scale. So we have a rather circuitous route to locate M88, and the last jump is a leap of faith because there's so few reasonably bright stars in this area, which we've seen before. We'll start back at 11 Coma Berenices, which is where we started on the last hop. So move about 3 degrees to the lower left to 5th magnitude, 24 Coma Berenices. Now move about a degree and a half to the lower right to 5th magnitude, 25 Coma Berenices. Now here's the leap of faith. From 25 Coma, move 2¾ degrees to the right, and you should see the spiral form of M88 coming into your eyepiece. This last move is tough, so you may have to try it a couple times. M88 is one of 8 galaxies found in March 1781 by Charles Messier in the Coma Virgo region. He described the galaxy as a nebula without stars. But later, in the mid-1800s, Lord Rosse recognized M88 as a spiral, one of the 14 spiral nebulae known at that time. M88 lies in the dead center of the Virgo cluster, positioned 65 million light years away from Earth. So let's find our last target of the week right after this quick break.
Star hopping target number 3.
Messier 91 is a barred spiral galaxy in the extreme southern part of Coma Berenices. It's a member of the Virgo galaxy cluster and the faintest galaxy in Messier's catalog at magnitude 10.1. So this hop is considered difficult. For many years, M91 was one of the missing Messier objects because of a position error that Messier made when he was documenting the new entry. But a Texas amateur astronomer finally figured it out in 1969. Messier had recorded M91's position relative to M89 rather than M58, as he had thought, and the true identity of M91 was finally uncovered as NGC 4548. So the star hop to M91 is pretty ridiculous from our previous position on M88. 91 lies only about 2 degrees to the lower left of M88, so you can really move directly there, but it's another leap of faith. No bright stars between them. But there is one option. A fairly difficult move of a little over a degree to the lower left will find you an 8th magnitude star. From there, you can move a half degree directly down to locate the faint glow of Messier 91. So whether or not NGC 4548 is the original M91, it's still one of the largest barred spirals in the Virgo Coma Cluster. With a true diameter of over 100,000 light years, it lies 58 million light years from Earth. So the realm is a spooky place. There are so few foreground stars and tons of faint fuzzies to confuse. We saw three good ones tonight. We started off with the reasonably bright lenticular galaxy M85. Then we took the star hopping expressway bypass around the core of the Virgo cluster to locate the beautiful spiral Messier 88, an Andromeda galaxy mini-me. Lastly, we struck out into the dark to find the faintest galaxy on the Messier list, the barred spiral M91. So that does it for this week's episode. You can find the show notes on our website at starhopping.org/SH051, where you can comment and leave any questions that you may have. You can also contact me personally on Twitter at StarhoppingMan, where I'd love to help you with any astronomy or observing questions. So feel free to reach out. I'm here to help. Well, thank you very much for joining me here, and I'll see you next time with more star hopping tips and tricks. Hey, thank you so much for hanging out with me here on Star Hopping. I publish new episodes every other week on Thursdays. Make sure you subscribe to the channel by clicking on the logo down there in the right-hand corner so you don't miss a single episode. And for some more star hopping content, visit my website at starhopping.org. You can click on this icon right here to visit. See you next time on Star Hopping.